10 seconds. Can you guys bring my clicker in here after?
4, 3, 2.
Thanks so much for joining us here on this Wednesday edition of FSC Weather. I'm Casey Cloud.
And I'm Sarah Bogofsky.
It's been a pretty nice day across our region here on this Wednesday, but as we get later into the week and later into this day, we've seen that cloud cover start to increase over our area.
The sun hasn't been out as much as it has been in the past week. The clouds are pushing in, so it's going to be more of a gloomy kind of rest of our week.
Yeah, so we're going to watch that closely as we get later into this week, into the weekend, as by the time we get into Sunday, we could have a pretty substantial chance for some rain to make it in toward our area.
We'll have to make sure we have our umbrellas to class then.
Yeah, absolutely. Make sure you do carry those, because especially on Monday, that chance will be there as people are headed out to class on Sunday. Got to watch out for people headed to church. So that's something to really keep our eyes on in toward Sunday and in Monday.
Yeah, it's a gloomy way to begin the week, but hopefully the sun will be back as the next week progresses.
Yeah, we'll monitor that very closely, because and it's going to really make for nicer weather conditions as we do get in toward Monday and in toward Tuesday as well here across our region. And that will be good following that rain, even on Wednesday, making for nicer conditions. And we'll be talking about that throughout the show and in that 7-day forecast as well, as we'll be talking about those increased chances for some moisture.
Mm-hmm. It'll be pretty wet over Sunday and Monday, but hopefully it dries out. I don't want to have too much of that. I don't know if I keep talking.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. I'll go ahead and take a look here at the overview of the weather situation here on your Wednesday. We're talking about some showers and thunderstorms in the central part of our country on your Wednesday. As you can see, down towards San Antonio, Dallas as well, there are some showers and thunderstorms. Also in the central U.S., getting into toward Kansas City, setting some snow up toward Bismarck as well, monitoring that very closely for you. Now, there's current temperatures 85 here in the metro area, 81 at the coast, 76 in Carrabelle. A little cooler down there. That's because of a sea breeze bringing in some cooler temperatures in toward those areas. And as we get, though, in toward the forecast for tonight, we'll be seeing 64 degrees. There will be some isolated showers possible here, though we are expecting some nice temperatures. It's been kind of on the cool side last few weeks, especially before break, but it's really started warming up, bringing in nicer weather conditions. Those winds will be on the calm side, maybe up toward 5 miles an hour, though. And then we'll start to shift as the front does come in. We'll be telling you more about this throughout the rest of the weather show here. Some isolated thunderstorms are possible as well. For me and Sarah, we're going to talk about the weather situation here even some more. We're going to be talking about some local weather history in terms of the way of some thunderstorms that did move through 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Back 20 years ago, there was pretty severe thunderstorms in the area. It was March 18th of 1995, and there was quite a bit of hail, actually. There was sizable hail hitting the area.
Yeah, there were some severe thunderstorms. We're talking about 3 miles west of Sadie Grove. There was some hail in the order of about 0.75 inches to 1.75 inches in diameter, which is pretty big. And in the city of Bainbridge, they had some golf ball-sized hail there.
I certainly wouldn't want to get hit by that. I almost wonder if they were playing golf with those pieces of hail.
Yeah, it's really interesting situation in that area. Very big, and so it's hail. Sometimes you can get even bigger hail. But right now, Sarah, you're going to go ahead and take us over to our first local forecast.
Around the area right now, we're seeing pretty much 80s uniformly across the board. It's 79 up in Valdosta, but largely seeing 86 Tallahassee, 81 up in Thomasville. Very uniform for today's highs. Looking at the clouds and rain that have just moved into our area so far today, it was pretty clear the earlier today, but the clouds pushed in as a result of a low pressure system that is headed our way, bringing a stationary front with it. Currently in the Big Bend, we have 85 here in Tallahassee, 82 in Quincy, 79 up in Thomasville, a little bit cooler up north, and down along the coast, we have 76 in Carrabelle and 77 in Apalachicola. So we see cooler temperatures down there because of sea breezes that'll keep it a little bit more mild in the area. Now the current winds, we see pretty much anywhere from 4 to 6 miles an hour. We have 6 miles an hour here in Tallahassee, 7 up in Bainbridge, only 4 down in Carabel, and 0 over in Wilma, so they're not seeing very much going on right now. Now moving into our temperatures and radar. You will see the red down here is showing the 80s we've been seeing lately, moving up into cooler down 70s, 60s, up towards the north. And you will see over here we have some precipitation over around Louisiana that may be coming our way in the next few days. Now, what to expect? You see, we have a very large low pressure system along with a stationary front cutting across the country over right here near Tallahassee through to Jacksonville. And that low pressure, as it progresses, is going to bring the precipitation a little bit to our north, so it shouldn't be that heavy. We have around 30% chance for most days, but we will see it get wet and overcast. And that will continue moving along, sitting around near Orlando, and bringing some of that weather over to there as well. It'll push back up north, bringing some of it out of our area as the time moves on. Now over to tonight, we'll see 64 in Tallahassee, basically 60s within the area. Isolated showers will be hitting us tonight, so keep an eye out if you're out tonight. Tomorrow, isolated thunderstorms, about 35% chance of rain. It could come either way, just make sure you're prepared. The week ahead, you'll see 82 in Tallahassee, 80s for Thursday and Friday largely. It'll cool down as that front pushes into the area. We see 60% chance of rain Sunday, 50% Monday, and clearing up a little bit for Tuesday and Wednesday.
All right, thank you so much, Sarah. Let's take a bigger look at things around the southeast. We're looking at 85 degrees in Tallahassee, 81 Montgomery, 79 Mobile. It's pretty warm down here in the southeast, not quite as warm as some other places were a few days ago. Well, me and Tyler are going to talk to you about that a little later. But it's looking very nice out. We saw some, you know, cloudy skies, but mostly sunny. Nice action there. Look at these temperature changes. Kind of similar throughout the Tallahassee, Big Bend region. Not too much of a different temperature change. About 4 degrees cooler today than it was yesterday. Down in Miami, we're looking at no change in temperature. But look at South Carolina, North Carolina, Tennessee, Arkansas, a little bit in Louisiana and Texas in there. They're dropping temperatures like crazy. 27 degrees cooler today at this time than it was yesterday in Little Rock. 24 Shreveport. And that's something fun to look at right there. These dew points, still springtime, relative humidities linked to the dew point very closely. 30% relative humidity, still really pretty dry for the southeast. Summertime, we might see these relative humidities be up in the 80s or 90s this time of day. But we do see some 90s over in Texarkana region right there, getting close to the western edge of the Mississippi. Bringing you some moisture conditions right there that you can see plenty of that because of that rain clouds action coming right there. There's a little bit of a low pressure system peeking into that region there, moving northwest soon to come to Tennessee. Might bring us some action down here in the southeast for us the next few days. We're going to see some rain coming at us. Might not push all the way down into South Florida, but plenty of upper level moisture is what we're going to be seeing in the next few days. Those relative humidities are relatively dry on the surface for now. But as this progresses, this moisture is going to come from aloft, and it's going to bring us some wetter weather coming at us. But for tonight, we're looking at 65 degrees Tallahassee. Another cool night, getting close to the dew point there a little bit. And 55 in Savannah, quite cool up north. There's plenty of cool temperatures north of the Mason-Dixon line. It's kind of cut off by the screen here, but plenty of nice 70s in Key West and some maybe portions of Southern Texas, see peeking into the low 70s tonight. Not getting too cool for them. Beautiful night. Maybe not so much because of this rain coming at us for a late evening. We're going to see some isolated thunderstorms. But right now, we're going to pass it off over back to Casey and Sarah at the desk.
Thanks so much, guys. Let's go ahead and get right into this. In fact, we'll talk about your weather history here in New England in 1936. There was a second heavy rainstorm. This led to the greatest New England flood in the history of that area. And in Pinkham Notch, New Hampshire, they had 10.97 inches of this rain in just a two-day period. That's impressive rain, and that can cause serious conditions. And that really kind of reminds us to just make sure if you can't see the water and how deep that is that's covering the road, just make sure you remember the National Weather Service's mantra, turn around, don't drown.
Mm-hmm. It's always better to be safe than sorry, so it's good to keep your cars out of danger.
And then in the Midwest in 1971, there was a powerful storm that brought winds over 100 miles an hour on this day as well, and that caused some pretty significant damage in that area. But right now, to go ahead and broaden the national picture out, we'll go ahead and take it over to Tyler.
Tom brought you the Southeast. I'm going the whole enchilada in the entire United States. Right now, we do have some flood advisories, mainly along the Mississippi River and up into the Ohio River Valley. They saw a lot of rain along with some snowmelt up into the Ohio River Valley that is causing some flooding concerns right along those riverbanks. There's also, believe it or not, some snow over in Denver, Colorado in the Rocky Mountains. And also, there is a possibility of some snow in the far northern New England areas as we go later on into the week. Current conditions right now. We are warm right now in Tallahassee. It is 85 degrees, 76 in New Orleans. But you can see how much cooler it is up to the north. That's sort of expected in mid-March, just see 30s and 40s in the plains. What's not expected is the 27 in Boston, the winter that never ends, even as spring starts to rear its head going to Friday when we welcome them the first day of spring. Temperatures across the country. Warmer temperatures across the West. I remember 2 days ago when I was here, it was much cooler there, so they warmed back up. The cool air is actually spread out to the east and just north of our region. In fact, Wilmington, North Carolina is 30 degrees colder now than it was 24 hours ago. Dallas, Texas, Little Rock, Arkansas, St. Louis, Missouri. Those areas are getting a lot of rain and a couple of snow showers, mainly up in the Bismarck, North Dakota, and Minneapolis, Minnesota. It's still March for them, which still means pretty cold. Nothing like that around here. We had some clouds coming in, maybe a couple of showers. The best chance of that will be north of Highway 84 and across South Georgia. And we got some rain, mainly to the northwest, as I showed you, over towards Little Rock, Arkansas. The rain chances tomorrow aren't going to be tremendous, but they will temper our temperatures down so that we won't be seeing the upper 80s that we saw over the last couple of days. Broadening out the view, you can see the rain across the Mid-South and Mississippi River Valley. That's really not helping with the flood issues there. And we have, that's going to be moving to the east, but as it does so, the amount of rain will be lessening, and that's why we won't be seeing a lot of rain until the weekend. We got a couple of snow showers, as I said before, across North Dakota and Minneapolis, Minnesota, the Moorhead area, and that's only about 1 or 2 inches of snow, not a big deal for them. But now let's send it back over to Tom with our next segment.
All right, we are going to take a look closer to home. We're going to take it back to Tallahassee, where everybody loves to know where the weather is like. For some of us, it's our viewing region right here, if you take a look at those counties highlighted. And we want to know what the story is, right? Right now, 85 in Tallahassee, pretty warm for late afternoon. It's getting towards, you know, it's time to maybe break out the tank tops and shorts. It's going to be nice out and maybe take a trip to the beach. While it's not raining as much, but we're not going to see some of that because of these dew points. 50 degrees in Tallahassee. Not too high, but that's high enough with some action from a low pressure system. It's going to bring us some precipitation over the next few days here. We see these clouds moving on in with the white clouds there notifying some higher clouds. This grayish signifying some lower lying clouds, more like stratus. But we're going to see eventually that trend is going to get a little bit more and more towards those white high clouds, bringing us some rain for us. But we can see a little sea breeze action kind of peeking in there. That's more of a summertime kind of thing. We see the wind coming off of the water and coming onto the land because of temperature differences, making different kinds of buoyancy. But looking at the satellite radar, we have this system right here associated with low pressure over Texas. It's going to gently move nice and slowly over towards us, bringing some of this precipitation along with this low pressure, right? It's going to bring us some precipitation, right? Going to get a little wet a few days here. We might see a few thunderstorms coming at you the next few days. And then it's going to keep moving on. And we're going to see this as this system progresses and moves a little bit further northeast, bringing them some action. It's going to clear us out a little bit But for tonight, we're looking at 64 degrees in Tallahassee, 20% chance of rain. But as we push into tomorrow, we might see some more of that action come out. Maybe a little bit of thunder. Showers coming at you. Nice temperatures, really. That wind coming from the southeast at 5 miles per hour for you. Pretty calm day for us, and it's going to be amazing because I like to see a little rain every now and then. Brings us a little bit of moisture. You know, you get those springtime flowers growing. I got a little plant myself. I'm proud of it. A little succulent little thing. It's beautiful. We got some plants growing in the springtime. Flowers beautiful. 82 tomorrow. Some showers coming at you. Isolated thunderstorms, but not too much to worry about for severe threat. But always make sure if you hear some thunder in the air, if it's within 30 miles, you might want to watch out, stay inside, and assume proper lightning safety tips. 30 miles within 30 minutes. You should probably stay inside. Keep an eye out. The wind for you tomorrow, east, southeast to southwest, coming at you 10 miles an hour. A little bit more breeze coming off of the coast there for us. And it's going to be beautiful. But we're going to take a look at the 7 days. If it'll take us here, we're going to look at 35% chance of rain for tomorrow. Some more action. Get a little bit warmer into the after that rain there. And I'm going to go and take us with Tyler at the desk talking about some national weather history, right?
Yes, actually the strongest and one of the most deadly tornadoes in history. 1935.
Yeah, 1935. They called it the Tri-State Tornado, actually 1925.
Oh.
And it went across Missouri, Illinois, and Indiana, traveling over 219 miles.
In fact, most tornadoes actually only go about 2 or 3 miles, so this was a really historic record breaker for that region. And it caused over 600 deaths, mainly because, you know, they didn't have the warnings that we had now.
Exactly. That was a long time ago, almost 100 years ago. There was 11 other tornadoes that day, but we always have to make sure. Stay safe when there's severe weather coming at us. We're getting into that severe weather for the Tornado Alley,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, March and April are very, very big months when it comes to the weather in the Midwest. But now we're going to send it back to the wall.
With you, Tyler, right? Wait, it's me? It's me. It's actually me. Sorry, guys. We had a little confusing setup today. We had a little bit of a jumble. But I'm going to take you for a look in Florida. We're going to take a scan around. We saw the satellite and radar a few seconds ago. Not too much action, just some clouds up by us. Very funny. 85 Tallahassee, 81 in Miami. Not too much of a difference in temperatures. A little warmer here than it is in Miami. Strange enough to see. We usually see it's warmer up there. 66 degrees in Jacksonville right now. That's crazy right there. Almost a 20 degree temperature change in only like 150, 200, 300 miles, something like that, right? That is crazy temperature differences. But these relative humidities, 30% relative humidity in Tallahassee, kind of dry for right now. But as we see that building with that moisture coming from the Texas area, and the 62% relative humidity in Miami for us. There's a beautiful picture here today. Most of this is noise. But if you look closely, you see a little line right here just across St. Mark's and a little line coming closer to Panama City right there, and that's called a sea breeze front, and that happens when the cooler, moister air off of the ocean, or the Gulf of Mexico in this case, comes over the land and meets the drier, warmer air, and it makes a little bit of a line, and the radar picks that up. And we see a few instances of this around the state, and this is what normally in the summertime causes these heavy thunderstorms we see in the lightning corridor of Florida between Tampa and Orlando. We have a little bit of sea breeze right here. If you look later in the day, whoop, that little line right there, that's called our sea breeze front. And it's amazing to see even more in Miami here. Calm weather, a little bit of noise, but here we see a little bit more of that sea breeze front coming at you. And it's a nice thing to look at to see, hey, you know, why do those thunderstorms pop up in the summertime? It's because of these little fronts right here. They kick up some action and they start the initiation for those thunderstorms to grow. And it is great to see how things work in the world, isn't it? Tonight, 68 in Tampa, 68 Orlando, pretty consistent around the state, mainly staying within the 60s, low 60s, Jacksonville and Pensacola, Tallahassee, 65 for you. A little bit warmer down south like we usually see. And for tomorrow, we're going to see plenty of clouds for southern Florida, but mainly a little bit of peak of sunshine for you. In Miami, 84 degrees, 85 for highs down there. 82 with some clouds, possibly some thunderstorms, pushing across the panhandle into 77 degrees for us at a high temperature. In Jacksonville, it is going to be a little bit of a wet few days here, But I'm going to take it back to the desk. I'm going to give it over to Casey here talking about...
I'll be talking about the tri-state area, in fact. And as we do so, we will see here that the temperature is 85 right now in Tallahassee. It's a little bit on the warm side here in the metro area. But some of our outlying areas sitting a little bit cooler, 77 in Valdosta, 73 in Panama City. It's a little bit cooler as a sea breeze has come in as well along the coastal regions, and that has brought temperatures down around Apalachicola as well as Panama City. And Tom was touching on this, where Jacksonville already 66 degrees because of a breeze out the ocean bringing in very cool weather conditions. This especially at the beach where this weather station is. And you can see Savannah, similar situation there in towards southeast and southwest or south central Georgia. Now, your current relative humidity tells the story, 30% in Tallahassee, 66% in Panama City. We do have some more moisture trying to move in from the west here. And just on the edge of our screen, we do have some in toward Mississippi and in the wood Louisiana as well. And that's trying to make its way closer than that will as we get in toward Thursday. And that will bring an increased chance for some shower activity as well as maybe an isolated thunderstorm. So we'll be keeping our eyes on that very closely. Those temperatures, they have gone down a little bit over what they were 24 hours ago. 4 degree difference and 4 degree drop in temperature in the Tallahassee area. Now Jacksonville, much cooler because of that breeze off the ocean. 19 degrees cooler there, 23 degrees cooler up in Savannah. It really does tell the story of that breeze coming off the ocean, bringing in those cooler weather conditions there. Very gusty winds upwards of 20 miles an hour in some of these areas. Now, it's all clear across our metro area, but as we get further out toward the west, we do see some showers, again, right on the edge of your screen here in southwest Mississippi. They're kind of trying to make their way back in toward the tri-state region here. As we get later in toward this evening and into tomorrow, the chance of rain is increasing, so that's something to keep our eyes on very closely here. Now, tonight, though, we do see 65 degrees here in the metro area, 64 in Panama City. Core temperatures, though, still feels a little bit like winter up in toward Macon, Georgia. We're talking about 51 degrees there. Savannah, 55 degrees as well. Some of that core air trying to make its way a little bit closer toward our area, but it's really going to have trouble doing that. Tomorrow, only getting to 52 in Macon, a pretty big contrast with that front parked over southern Georgia, northern Florida, but 82 in Tallahassee, 30 degrees. And just a trip really up the interstate from Interstate 10 taking to 75 in toward that area. So again, we'll be watching that closely. 81 Gainesville, 77 in Jacksonville. So those temperatures a little bit on the warmer side as we get downstate, Tampa 82. Chance of some thunderstorms again in toward some of the North Florida zone. So that's something to keep our eyes on very closely here in the weather situation. But right now we'll go ahead and take it over back to the desk with Tyler and Tom.
Thank you, Casey. You know, it was very warm in Tallahassee over the last couple of days. Yesterday it got up to 89 degrees, which was not only the high temperature for the state, but the warmest it's been all year. But even that pales in comparison to the 91 degrees in North Platte, Nebraska.
Yeah, the record temperature North Platte, Nebraska on Monday afternoon, and it dropped all the way to 27 degrees Fahrenheit within 12 hours to the next morning.
Could you imagine dressing for that? You'd have to on about like a parka and then go to tank top and flip-flops.
Yeah, I find it hard to believe, you know, like, what if somebody went to bed and they really didn't pay attention to the weather? They woke up to go to work the next morning. Oh, it's going to be warm. They walk outside freezing cold. So
that's why you have to watch a certain kiss. Something like that happens, you don't get caught in a 60-degree.
Yep. And for speaking of some cold temperatures, we're going to see some maybe snow action coming at the northeast Friday to Saturday, maybe 3 to 6 inches of snow coming.
Which is really weird because it's the start of spring. But now we're going to send it back over to the wall with Casey.
Thanks so much, guys. Kind of getting in toward the local weather picture now in toward our area. We will see, first off, we're sitting 65 in the Tallahassee area tonight, but kind of going ahead and getting in toward tomorrow, 70, 82 here. But locally, we do see that there is just a few clouds making their way in from the west, and that's going to cause some overcast conditions here making their way through our area here on this Wednesday. We'll be watching that because that is bringing that increase in moisture with them. 50 degrees at dew points and 30% at humidity again. We're starting to see an increase a little bit in stickiness and moisture. 85 degrees is that temperature. Those winds, not too big of a factor at only 6 miles an hour. 95 here in the metro area, 86 in Wilma, a little bit warmer there. 82 in Quincy, you get the idea, low to mid 80s across the area. But these will kind of stick around as we get in the next few days before we have a next weather maker that comes through and drops these temperatures a little bit, which I'll see you here in a 7-day forecast. 76 in Caribou as well, 77 in Apalachicola. And those winds, 6 miles an hour in Tallahassee. Now you can see the wind direction changing here, Caribou to St. Marks. The winds here coming in toward these areas from the sea breeze, and those directions have shifted in toward those southern areas. Now, what to expect as we get in toward later this evening, we do have a low pressure area and a stationary front, and we'll be watching this as it does bring us an increase for some moisture here over our area as we get in toward Thursday, a few showers and a few, maybe an isolated thunderstorm or so. Later on Thursday, some of those thunderstorms, some of that activity will kind of subside a little bit, move a little bit closer toward northeast Florida. Southeast Georgia, they could have a little bit higher chance for some rain and thunderstorms in toward those areas. And as we get into Friday, we'll see a little bit of clearing conditions for the most part. There could still be a few clouds around, though, but at least we won't be seeing precipitation on Friday and Saturday. Just a very low chance of that occurring. Now, going ahead and getting into toward the beach and voiding forecast for your Thursday, we do see those winds southeast at 5 to 10 knots. There won't be too big of a chop on the waters. Showers will be around and maybe an isolated thunderstorm, something to keep an eye on. Chances relatively low, but there is enough instability around that we could have a few showers. Again, the time change a couple weeks ago, we see those times moving further and further later in the evening, giving you more daylight to go outside in the evening. 64 tonight, though, here in Tallahassee, 64 in St. Marks, low to mid-60s across the board, 62 Thomasville, temperatures pretty nice and seasonable for this time of year. Now, in that 7-day forecast, we see temperatures the next couple of days in the low to mid-80s, starting to cool down, though, as we get into toward the weekend and early next week with an increased chance for rain. But right now, I'll go ahead and take it back over to the desk with Tyler and Tom.
All right. Thanks for playing a little bit of segment ping pong with us, Casey. I feel like we've been going back and forth the entire show.
Pretty
just
much.
Just passing it back. But we're going to ping pong it all the way over to Australia right now.
Yes. Tropical cyclone Nathan. There's been a big surge of activity in the Australian basin because of a pulse of energy that has really just bubbled up over the past couple of days.
Yeah. And it's category one right now, expected to strengthen and as it approaches the Australian coast. But back home, even though it feels like it's been springtime for a little bit here, official springtime doesn't really start till Friday, right?
Yes, and actually once spring comes, it'll actually cool down into the 70s for the rest of the week.
Yeah, we've been seeing some of those 80s, some of those cloudier skies, but once we get into early next week, we've seen those clear skies come back at you.
Well, thank you for joining us. If you want more, you can like us on Facebook.com/FSCweather, follow us on Twitter.com/FSCweather, and watch us anytime on Livestream.com/FSCweather. For FSCweather, I'm Tyler Von Harten.
And I'm Tom Mazzetti. We've had a great show with us today, a little bit short staff, but we made it work, guys.
Yes. Have a great night and hope to see you soon.
Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.